you will see with a live example how you can work with this new feature. In the last 10 minutes, I'm gonna answer to your questions, so feel free to write this question on the chat. If I'm not able to answer to all the question, I'm gonna respond you through the email. So let's get started, and first of all, let's see what is the Enterprise Project. The Enterprise Project is a new way to manage your enterprise web applications. As I said before, it's a feature included starting from WebRatio 7 Enterprise Edition. The idea is to have a unique project in which you can centralize the data definition and to reuse modules and pieces of models, which means that if you have different projects right now that shares the data model definition and also some business logic, in this moment you have to manage them separately. With the Enterprise Project, you can import all these projects inside the Enterprise one and share everything that is in common. Since the enterprise structure is composed by different sub-projects, in this way also the team working is improved because you can clearly divide the tasks between your team members. The Enterprise Project produced an enterprise web application, still Java, using the J2EE framework. And so the application server on which this web application can be deployed is an application server like JBoss that supports the deployment of ER packages. Let's go through now the structure of the Enterprise Project. As I said, the Enterprise Project is composed of different sub-projects. The core one is the data model project, in which you can define all the data structure that is shared between all your project. This is a mandatory project and must be unique. For this reason, when you try to create a new enterprise project inside WebRatio, the wizard asks you also for the name for the data model project. Then you can add to the enterprise project one or many web model projects. A web model project is a project containing all the business logic you want to include in your web application. You can have different web model projects because you can also use the enterprise project in order to manage a set of web applications. If you think about, for example, an intranet in which you have a CRM system and a calendar, you may want to have this business logic divided into two different projects. So you will create two web model projects, but both of them can share the same data structure. So they can reuse the same data model definition and the same database. That's the basic idea of the enterprise project. Then, if you have some common business logic that can be reused in many web model projects, you can add to the enterprise project one or many module projects. This project is optional, so if you do not need it, you can avoid to define this kind of projects. And the module project contains only the definition of what we call module. A module is an object containing a business logic and can be an operation or an hybrid modules. This means that an operation is a set, is a sequence of operations, and the hybrid module is a module in which you can also define pages with contents. Then you have the chance also to attach to the web model projects a set of BPM projects, which means that you want to add to the enterprise project itself the implementation of some business processes. So you can have an enterprise project having the definition and implementation of some business processes, and also an enterprise application with a section that doesn't have anything related to the business process itself. So you can have a mixed web application. A portion of that uses the BPM projects and the other one doesn't. Depending on the structure of the enterprise project, you can have a different package when you generate the project itself. And since the enterprise project is a brand new kind of project, in order to be able to generate and deploy this kind of project, you have a new option available in the main menu. So during the development phase, in order to generate the project, you have the new option Generate Full Enterprise Project. This option generates for you all the sub-projects contained inside the enterprise project, and so prepares the web app folder. Instead, when you want to deploy the application resulting from the enterprise project, you can use the deployment configuration dialog. This is also a new feature of WebRatio 7, in which we have refactored what you in WebRatio 6 you had in the deployment plans. And basically, this dialog allows you to configure everything that can be different from the production environment and the development environment. For example, you can change the database configuration, the web services configuration, the SMTP server configurations, and so on. At the end of this configuration, it's also possible to create a sequence of tasks that allows you to customize the content of the deployment package. So in this figure, you can see which are the available tasks. You can choose one of or many tasks from this list. You can create your own sequence in order to have the package to be deployed on the application server of the customer. Once we generated the project using the generate command or the deployment configuration, you have something like the figure you see on the right inside this slide. The web app folder is more complex than the standard one, since every project that you included inside the enterprise project becomes a specific folder in the deployment structure. And here are the rules applied in order to construct the deployment folder. Basically, you have a jar file for the enterprise project containing all the common runtime configuration files, that is, for example, the log configuration level. Then you have a WAR file for the enterprise project that contains all the configuration about the controller, which is struts. Then you have a jar file related to the data model project. In this jar, all the information regarding the data structure are stored, so all the classes related to the entities defined in the data model and all the connection information. Then you have a set of WARs, one for each web project. Web model project that you have inside your enterprise project that contains all the business logic that you model inside the specific project. So basically you have a set of JSP pages and application folders, for example, for CSS and JavaScript resources. For each module project, you have also a WAR that contains all the module definition. Then there are some generic folders that contain all the common information, like the lib folder containing all the libraries and the metainfo folder that contains all the information related to the structure of the enterprise project. So now let's see with a live example how you can work using the enterprise project. The example is an enterprise web application in which we want to let the employees of a company be able to request a vacation or submit an expense report. Both this feature can be intended as business processes. So inside the Web Ratio, I've already prepared two BPM projects, which are sample projects that you can easily download. And using these two BPM projects, I want to build my enterprise project. To create a new enterprise project, you can click on the main menu and choose File, New Enterprise Project. The wizard asks you a name for the new enterprise project. And in the next step, since the data model project is mandatory, the wizard asks you also for the name for the data model project. Once the wizard has been completed, the tool creates the new structure and opens all the projects in the main work area. So here we have the Employees Manager, which is the enterprise project. And as you can see in the main area, you can see the structure of your enterprise project. Right now we have just one project, that is the Employees Manager. The Employees Manager.db is the data model project, and in this project we just have the Data Model tab that allows us to create all the data structure of the information managed by our enterprise web application. Now we want to create the business logic of our project. So let's add a new web model project to our enterprise one. From the main menu, I can choose File, New Web Model Project. In this case, the wizard asks us in which enterprise project we want to place the new project, and to give a name to the project itself. In this web model project that I called Expense Report Manager, I'm going to synchronize the expense report business process. When I end the wizard, the project is opened. As you can see, this project is composed by a set of site views, service views, and module views. The structure of the enterprise project has been updated so that now we have one web model project inside the enterprise one. And now we just have to synchronize the business process regarding the expense report. So I want to delete this site view because it's not necessary. And right-clicking in the main area, using the Synchronize BPM to Web Project option, I can choose one of the BPM projects that I have in my workspace, in this case the expense report, and ask to Web Ratio to create for me all the model necessary in order to implement this business process. So clicking on the Finish button, the tools creates some elements inside the web model project and inside the data model project and asks me if I want to reload all the projects in order to save all the changes. So I say yes, and everything is reloaded. As you can see, the Expense Report Manager now has three different site views. One that contains the basic login, one site view related to the administration of the business process, and the control view, which is the dashboard of every user of the Expense Report Manager. Also, the synchronization has created elements inside the Employees Manager database. As you can see from the three main entities that we had before, all this information, all this model has been added. This is the model related to the business process management. Now we have to do the same operations in order to add another web model project that will contain the implementation of the vacation request business process. So from the main menu, another time, we choose File, New, Web Model Project. I choose the enterprise project that is target, and then I have to choose a name for my project. I can do this operation because I can add many web model projects to the enterprise project. So after that, I have my new web model project here, and the structure of the enterprise project updates with the new element inside the web model project session. So as we have done before, we can remove this site view, which is empty, and we can synchronize the vacation request business process. The result is the same. The tool creates for me all the model needed in order to handle the vacation request business process. And as you can see, right now, the Vacation Request Manager contains these three site views, VP Administration, Control View, and Home. And also the Expense Report Manager contains the same list of site views. If we compare the content of these site views, for example, the home one, you can see that the content of these two site views is the same. So my idea now is that I don't want to manage twice the same information, but I want to share them so that I define the model just one time, and all the enterprise application will share this information. To do this, I can create a third web model project in which I'm going to add the shared content. So for the third time, we can choose File, New, Web Model Project. And this project will be called Administration because it will contain all the shared content. What we can do now is to select from one of the web model projects, for example, from the Expense Report Manager, all the shared content, so the three site views, and we can move the site views from this project to the administration one. Now that I've defined these three site views in a separate web model project, this information are seen by all the other web model projects. So I can remove the views that I had in the Expense Report Manager and in the Vacation Request Manager. So in the Vacation Request Manager, I can remove the three site views. Right now, the structure of my enterprise project is composed by one data model project, employees manager database, which is mandatory and unique, and three web model projects, administration, expense report manager, and vacation request manager. If we suppose that the structure of our project is complete, we have just to prepare the project for the generation, which means that first of all we need to decide which is the style, the graphic to be applied to each web model project. Usually, when a web model project or a web project is synchronized with a business process, the style attached, the style to be used for development purposes is the BPM style. This style cannot be automatically attached by the tool when you did the synchronization, because you can do the synchronization at any moment during the development. So you can have a web model project with some logic already modeled, in which you may have associated your custom style project, and so for this reason we do not want to override your setting. So in order to have a complete sample project, now we have to go inside all the web model projects and choose the BPM style, which allows us to easily have a demo of our enterprise project. Then in the administration view, in the administration web model project, we must choose from the three site views that we have, which is the home one. Home means that this site view will be the one accessed automatically by the web application when the user enters inside the administration web model project. And since we have this control view that is the dashboard for the business process users, and we want to this control view is the default one for all the business processes that we have implemented inside the enterprise project, we can set the control view as the default control view. We have to go into the properties view, into the BPM tab, and check the default control view property. Then, looking to the structure of the Employees Manager Enterprise project, as you can see, one of the web model projects is highlighted with a different icon. Right now, the Expense Report Manager is the one that is different from the others. This is the concept of default web model projects. It's something very similar to the home site view. The meaning is that when the user will access the enterprise web application, the application must decide which is the web model project to be shown to the user at first. And the one that will be chosen is the one we set as default. So in our case, the default must be the administration, because it's the web model project containing the login page. In order to set this project as the default, we can right click on the project and choose refactor set default. Okay. Now we have to check if our project contains any error inside the model. So we can select each web model project, starting for example from the administration one, and going into the project node, we can check if the model is correct or not using find model problems. If there's any error, it will be written inside the problems view. As you can see, right now we have two errors, and the errors must be solved in order to have a working application. With a double click, you can see exactly which is the element inside the project having the mistake. And in this specific case, the problem is that the logout unit that decides which is the site view to be served to the user after the user logs out from the web application contains a reference to an invalid site view. Basically, this is due to the fact that we have cut and paste these three site views from a project to another one. So to solve, we just have to choose in the properties view a new site view that will be the one the user sees after the logout. So it could be the home site view, the one that contains the login page. And we have to solve all the errors. Notice that, as usual, the problems dialog doesn't refresh automatically. So if we want to be sure that our project doesn't contain any error, we just have to search another time for the model problems. And as you can see, now we just have two warnings. The same operation must be done on the other web model projects. And as you can see, the error is always the same, so it's very easy to solve in this case the error. So we can fix the vacation request manager and also the expense report manager, choosing the correct site view. Okay. The same thing must be done on the employees manager database. Here, in order to be able to test our web application, we need to add a database definition. So we need to say that this data model is attached to a specific data source that is a real database. So right-clicking on the data model, you can choose the Add Database option in order to add a connection to a database. Let's suppose to use a Postgres database, Postgres 9. Here you have a list of all supported databases. And just configure the connection. Remember that you must define and create the database using the specific database administrator application, because WebRatio doesn't create the database for you. So when I write here the employee's manager name, it means that or I have already defined this database, or I need to create the database externally before trying to connect to this database. In my case, I have already prepared the employees manager database here, so I can try to connect to it using the refresh option. As you can see here, you have the progress. If the connection is successfully, you have here a gray, green icon. And now we need to create all the information we designed inside data model on the database using the synchronize option. Since the database supports the schemas, we need to choose one of the available schemas that will be the one containing all the table's definition. In the synchronization dialog, you have the list of the elements that the tool wants to export. So we can just say export all objects and go to the next step, which shows us which is the DDL code that WebRatio wants to execute on the database. So we can just press finish and see if everything is generated correctly. After the operation, all the information are mapped, which means that for each element that you have in the data model, you have a corresponding element inside the database. And as you can see in the metadata element here, you have the list of the tables created on the project. Now we are ready to generate our project. Since it's an enterprise project, in order to generate everything, we need to select the enterprise project itself. Then we need to choose which is the output path, so where we want to create the web app folder. The default output path is the one written in the output path property in the properties view. And as you can see, by default, the tool proposes the web apps lock. This variable points to the web apps folder of the Tomcat, which cannot be used for an enterprise project. So what you must do is to change the path pointing to the web app folder, for example, of AJBoss. I prepared this morning a variable that is JBoss lock that points to the deployments folder of my JBoss installation. So what I can do is to change this property and write JBoss lock. And after that, I can generate the project. To generate the project, you can select the enterprise project and then choose from the main toolbar generate full enterprise project. And on the bottom left right you can see the progress of the generation. At this moment WebRatio is generating all the projects included inside the enterprise one. So the database data model project and all the web model projects included. We can have a look on the generated folder. So as you can see, we have an AR folder employees manager containing all the information about our project. And as you can see, we have a jar for the database, a jar and a war for the enterprise project, and one war for each web model project. Also, WebRatio creates this file that is needed by JBoss in order to be able to deploy the application. So now, if we want to test our application, we need to start JBoss. And to navigate our web application. Just a few moments. You can check if JBoss has been started going to the main directory, and after that, if you want to access your enterprise web application, you must use the same name that you have placed for the enterprise project, so employees manager. As you can see, the user has been redirected to the administration web model project and to this page that is the login page. Now what we need to do in order to be able to test our web application is to go to the administration view, which is the other side view contained inside the administration web model project, and to update all the process definition. This operation creates for us all the information about the business process and also a set of test users. So if we go back to the login page, as you can see, now we have a set of users that can be used in order to test the web application. So for example, if I log in as the employee, I expect to see the dashboard. The dashboard is still contained inside the administration web model project. The user can start two different business processes, the new expense report and the new vacation request. These are the two business processes that we have synchronized in our enterprise project. So we can choose to start, for example, the expense report. And the application brings the user into this page, that is the page related to the first activity of the business process expense report. So what I can do is to write down a title for the expense report and an amount, and then to complete the activity. Every time that the user completes an activity, the dashboard updates itself, showing to each user which is the list of the to-do items. In this case, the list is empty because if we look to the business process definition, after the employees has submitted a new report, that is the edit report activity, the next activity depends on the amount of the expense, and the next activity can be a review report that must be accomplished by the supervisor, or it can be directly following this flow, the confirm receipt done by the treasurer. So the employees doesn't have any other activity to do in this specific project, in this specific business process. That's why the work items list is empty. If we want to go on with the test, we must log out and enter as a supervisor. The supervisor will see a notification saying that it has a new activity. It has in the work item list the new activity review report, and it can decide to work on this activity. Again, the application brings the user inside the page in order to complete the specific task. So it can write down and complete the information and end the activity. Basically, this is the same concept that is applied to the other business process vacation request. So I don't want to go in further details about how the web application works, because this is the standard behavior of a business process based web application. The new thing is that this web application is an enterprise web application obtained using an enterprise project. And we have seen how it's possible to create a new enterprise project from scratch. Also, you can do another thing, which I think is very interesting. You can import inside the enterprise project an already existing web project. So I've already prepared in my workspace the ACME sample project, which is a simple web project showing a product catalog. And now I want to show you how you can import the ACME project inside our enterprise project. From the main menu, you can choose File, Import, then select Web Project into Enterprise Project. The next step wants to close all the open projects in order to improve the performances. So we just go next. All the projects are closed. You can choose which is the project that you want to import. And then in the next step, you must choose which is the target enterprise project. After that, a real wizard started asking you which are the elements that you want really to import inside the enterprise project. The idea is that all the data model definition must be imported by default. That's why the wizard asks you which is the name of the package that will contain all the data model about our web project. And you can change the name of the package if you want. And after that, you can choose which site views, service views, and model views you want to import inside the enterprise project. In this case, we can also select all the elements. The next step asks us for every element that you defined in the web project, like the providers or the databases, if we want to keep this element as the original version and so make the tool copy this definition inside the enterprise project, or if we already have an element that represents the same thing inside the enterprise project. So, for example, from the ACME database, I can choose whether I want to merge the database with the database one, which is the one defined in the enterprise project, or not. If I choose not, the result will be that we will have in the data model project two database definition. After that, I just have to click on Finish, and the tool automatically creates a new web model project inside the enterprise one, containing all the site views and service views and model views that I've chosen from the main wizard. The data model has been created inside the Employees Manager database project, and it's wrapped inside a package that is the ACME package. Then I can choose if I want to leave here this information or if this information are specifically handled by the Employees Manager ACME Web Model project. So I can decide that this package is not a shared information, but is a data structure handled only by the ACME project. So I can, if I want, move this definition inside the web model project. To do this, I can right-click on the package and choose Refactor Make Local to Web Model Project. In this way, I can move the ACME package with the related database element on one of the web model projects contained inside the enterprise one. And I can choose, for example, Employees Manager ACME. And now, if we look inside the web model project Employees Manager ACME, in the data model, we have the package ACME with all the entities defined inside. So in addition to the shared data model that you can define in the specific project, in this case Employees Manager DB, you can also have a portion of data structure specifically defined inside our model project. This operation, the import of a pre-existing web project, can be done several times, so you can create your own enterprise project starting from a set of existing web projects. In this way you can improve their management and you can share all the logic that is in common between all of them. So now I can answer to your question if there's any. Feel free to write. If you do not have any question right now, I can also answer you by email. We have a question that is if this webinar can be accessible in the future. We are working on this. In this moment we are recording the webinar, so our idea is basically to have this video available, I think, on our website. So the answer to this question is yes. And I'm waiting for 5 minutes if you have any further question about everything that we have seen, or any doubt, or everything you want to know about the enterprise project. Roberto Del Sordo is asking if there's a minimal version of JBoss to be used with the enterprise project. Yes, I've used the 7.1 version, and it will not be built in inside the WebRation. We will provide only the Tomcat installation, and you must download JBoss standalone. Tomcat cannot be used for the enterprise project because Tomcat is not able to deploy near file, and the enterprise project can be generated only in a near package. So for the enterprise project cannot be used. If you create a standard web project, you can use Tomcat as always. For the enterprise project, you must use an application server that is compliant with the J2EE framework. There's another question. The question is if I'm using multiple BPM inside an enterprise project, how we can decide which tasks can be viewed by the different role? This is done in the standard way. So when you draw the business process inside the BPM project, you can assign the task to a specific lane that corresponds to our role. So this is the very first place in which you can decide which role can accomplish a specific task. And then you can assign a specific user on a specific role. And this must be done or specifying in the business process the list of users, or as usual, creating the information inside the specific database connecting the user with the different roles. So this is not different from what you are doing right now with the Web Ratio 6 or 7 in the standard web project. Okay, the next question is that the employees in our demo can start the activity of both processes, and this is due to the fact that the roles is the same. Yes, exactly, because if we look at the business process definition, we have the employee lane both for the expense report and for the vacation request. So by default, when the tool creates the test users, the tool assigns the same user to both roles. That's why the demo user can access both the business processes. Of course, if this must be different for you, what you can do is, for example, to create a different to use a different name for the lane employee in the vacation request business process, so that you have two different roles inside the database definition, and you can decide to assign a user to the employee lane of the expense report, but not to the employee lane of the vacation request. So basically, this depends on the access rights that you specified for the user inside the database. The suggestion is, in this case, when you are going to define the business processes, if you may have these kind of differences, to use different names for different lanes in each process, so that you can configure in a very flexible way which user can achieve which specific task. Okay, since there's no further question for the moment, I'm gonna close the webinar. Thanks for your attention. Remember that if you have any further question or information, you can always write to support@webratio.com, and we are glad to help you and answer to everything you need. Thank you very much, and have a nice day.